If someone would ask me how different people are, I would answer without blinking, people are different totally.
The most terrifying sound you ever heard.
Oh dear, oh dear. What's my sound?
Oh, a barn owl screeching when I was really young.
Yeah.
Swooped in front of me, that screeched and swooped in front of me.
Yeah.
And I just stood, I couldn't move.
Thunder, first time of thunder.
Okay.
Yeah.
I think probably when planes really come low and they come low and they break the sound barrier right on top of you.
Right.
Yeah.
The most terrifying sound I ever heard was when I was in the fire service and I was in a burning building, and this building was about 6-7 stories high, and we were inside on the ground floor, and the lift fell.
It was burning. Fire,
yeah. Yeah, it's completely engulfed in fire, and the lift fell and hit the ground. We were not far from where we were standing, and lifts are very heavy, and it dropped virtually from the top floor, and the whole building shook, and the beams came down burning, and we got out pretty quickly.
And you was on the ground floor?
We were on the ground floor. We were going to go up, and then we decided that we were called out then. But that was very frightening.
What kind of smell from your childhood do you remember the most?
My mum's cooking. My mum's cooking.
I think the autumn leaves.
I used to like fresh, because the herrings when I was a kid were big, beautiful, mossy herrings.
Yeah.
And having those grilled for tea were beautiful. I love the smell of that grilling herring, grilled herring. Yeah.
Good.
That's one of them.
I think I fear that my children will be killed.
Not really, no. Okay. Just take life as it comes.
Okay.
Yeah, probably global warming.
What do I fear in our times? Well, because I live in New Zealand, and it's right down in the bottom quarter of the world, we're quite isolated, which I like very much.
Yeah.
But I don't think I'd like to live in England now, in this part of the world, because I think that there's things going to happen which we have no control over.
Okay.
So I'm quite happy
where
I live. Terrorism, there's all types of things. Countries are getting the atomic bomb weapons. And they're not going to be controlled unless we do something about it, address it. So I'm pleased we're out of it.
Do you think New Zealand's more safe?
Yeah, I do.
Economy, things like that, how things will end up.
Yeah.
You know, just general fears.
Yes, I do. I really do. The youngsters nowadays, they do seem, I don't know, they've got no discipline. There's no discipline in youngsters. There is. And teachers can't do anything, can they? No discipline.
Bloody bells.
Bloody bells.
Can you say that?
Yeah. Okay.
Oh, younger, I used to be dead scared of my teachers.
Yeah, yeah.
Really dead scared. But, you know, you did what you were told.
Now everything's changed, yeah.
Manners now, is it? No manners at all.
Anything and everything. All enjoy life. That's what I say, enjoy it.
Yeah.
You only hear once.
Not those awful people, comedians on the television. They never make me laugh, but I think it's, Have I Got News For You? That, which is very subtle, that kind of program.
Yeah.
And my children when they do silly things. But...
Oh, general things, you know, things that happen, people tripping up, you know, things that I shouldn't do, but...
Good comedy.
You like
TV?
Comedy?
Yeah.
No.
I like the stand-up comedians.
Ah.
Liam and all that.
Some comedies, some individual stand-ups makes me.
Most things, I think I've got a pretty good sense of humour. I love British humour.
Oh, we are. I think we are. We are a bit sick sometimes.
Like the Monty Python.
Yeah, that's brilliant. Monty Python, Spike Milligan. Yeah, yeah. There'll never be another Spike Milligan.
I like Monty Python. Yeah, 40 Towers. I think anything like that. Yeah, yeah. And I love their political satire. Yeah. And some of their political programs on TV are very good. Makes me laugh.
I just got a knife in here, what belonged to my father. I sort of carried that on.
Yeah. Well, yeah, I've got a phone.
Yeah.
I was supposed to phone for it. The phone could bring out a story.
Yeah.
Because I never had a phone until I met up with my daughter after 20 odd years.
Yeah.
And of course, when I went to Wales, she said, "Have you got a mobile phone, Dad?" Well, you better get one so we can talk. So, yeah, mobile phone.
What is your definition of freedom?
Well, well, don't really know on that one. Never thought about that, tell you the truth.
It's quite difficult to explain.
Yeah, that is a
something.
Yeah,
that's somewhere, but it's not.
That's right. That's there's something there somewhere, but very hard one to explain, as you say. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know what.
Do you feel a free man?
Yeah, I do in a way. Yes, but that's a good question. That is very good question. Yeah, I don't really know how to answer that one. Yeah. I don't honestly think.
Okay.
Be able to do what you want in life and enjoy yourself. Just about do what you want, really.
Yeah. What is your definition of freedom?
Well, free speech. Able to go where you want without being. I know we're being watched by Big Brother now with all the cameras, but
yeah.
That doesn't seem to play on your mind, really. You get on with your life and you go where you want. Probably you are being watched quite more than you think, actually. But able to say mostly what you want, what you feel.
Yeah.
You have to hold things back, don't you? Not to hurt people, but basically being able to do virtually what you want.
Yeah. Yeah. It's good.
My definition of freedom is that people are allowed to pursue their own course of happiness in whichever form it takes, as long as it doesn't impinge on other people's form of happiness.
Where I can live my life as I want and nobody interferes with it. I'm afraid these days everybody interferes with it, don't they? Speed cameras on every corner. So as I live in the country, I can sort of cocoon myself in a little hole and not worry about them.
What was your first feeling when you had your first car?
Freedom.
Freedom. That's the freedom, you got it.
Well, you see, there is that one too.
That's a bit of freedom,
freedom.
Well, when I bought my first car, I couldn't drive. So I bought my first car for my wife, really, because she could drive. I was at sea at the time, and I'd never driven before. And we got married, and we bought our first car, and I was still at sea, and my wife used to drive me around. So it was quite good.
Okay.
Hey. I felt good, you know. Yeah. I felt good to have achieved something, you know. Yeah.
Bit of freedom.
Sounds like
it. Oh, yeah.
That's lovely. Yeah. Yeah. Oh, really excellent. But how can I explain it to you? I don't see how I can.
Yeah, so what's happening? You're putting those on.
He's going to give me some sounds, and I've got to explain to you without speaking what they are.
What was the first one?
Oh, it's a piece of music which was like ripples, and then it had bouncy ball type things in between it.
You just can't, you know, to make it.
You can't talk. Can you hear the ball bouncing?
Mm-hmm.
And what do you do with that? Baby laughing is good. It's a lovely sound, baby laughing.
Oh, I love it.
Sound.
No. It sounds like a little brain. No. Gorgeous. No. I love that sound. It sounds like someone's tickling their tummy or something. Blowing raspberries or something. That's so cute.
That's quite funny.
Ooh. I'll get down and get up again, you know. Oh, that's bad. How about that?
That's very good.
That's horrible. Experimenting, giving me that. Yes, I bet you couldn't do it.
Just, you know, spontaneous.
I know I'm spontaneous, and yeah. I'm a bit old for being spontaneous, actually.
He wants some extra mature cheddar, no? Extra mature, about a year, you know. Good old green, good mind on it.
You know.
I like cheese. So okay. I like cheddar cheese.
Okay,
all right.
Thank you.
It's all right.
Yeah.
Pleasure.
Thanks for the interview.
You're welcome.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye, Peter.